Hi, I'm Paige Pearce with Sportsman's Warehouse, and today I want to talk to you guys about how to practice smarter, not harder. So we're going to start off by talking about target archery. How are you going to practice to make yourself the best that you can be? Now, there's two things that you need to understand and two things that you need to do when you're practicing. First, you need to look at how many arrows you're going to shoot per end at that tournament. Whether it be 3 or 5 or 6, what I would recommend is whatever that number is, practice double. So if I'm going to go to a tournament and shoot 3 arrows per end, I'm going to have 2 targets up and I'm actually going to shoot 6 arrows per end. Now the reason that I do that, when you shoot at home, you're very relaxed, your bow goes off really easy and everything just feels smooth. But when you're in a tournament and you get under that active tournament pressure, everything feels physically more tiring. So if you can shoot 6 arrows at home relaxed, it's probably the physical equivalent of shooting 3 arrows under pressure. So that's how I practice. Again, smarter, not harder, and I know that I'm not gonna get weak or fatigued on those last couple arrows of my end. Now the second thing that you guys need to do is look at the overall number of arrows that you're going to have to shoot within that tournament day. We shoot tournaments where it's as low as 30 arrows up to even 144 arrows in a day. Now you need to make sure that you can shoot at least 25 more arrows well than what you're gonna shoot in the tournament. Now what I've noticed is that if you can shoot double the arrows you're gonna compete with per end, then overall you will probably be okay. But if you're heading to a tournament where you have to shoot 72 arrows, don't only practice 30 and think that you're okay. If I was gonna shoot that, I'd probably practice about 100 arrows so I know that I'm good and strong, I'm not gonna fatigue within the arrows that are gonna count for that scoring round. Again, arrow count doesn't mean everything. It's important that when you're shooting quality arrows with good shots and proper form. Just going out there and flinging 300 arrows for the day is not going to make you a better archer. It's better to shoot 72 that matter, that are calculated, and that are the best shots that you can do, because really when you're practicing, you're gonna turn around and shoot that same way in a competition. Now we're gonna transition and talk about hunting. When it comes to hunting practice, it's very different than a tournament. You don't need to be able to shoot a high arrow count. You don't need to be able to shoot multiple arrows successfully at a time. Quite honestly, all of the work that you put into your hunt is going to come down to one arrow, one shot that is going to make or break probably your entire season. So with that, it's very important that you know the very first arrow out of your bow every time you go to shoot it is the best that it can be. What I would recommend is be able to shoot at least 20 arrows per time with your hunting bow. Also, one thing you want to test is that in cold weather and with a lot of extra clothing that you can still comfortably pull the poundage of your bow back. If you can shoot your hunting bow 20 arrows at a time and you're still feeling comfortable, then your poundage is probably good and you're going to be okay. So moving on from that, how I would recommend you do this is, before you go to shoot, do maybe 20 or 30 jumping jacks to get your heart rate up and get your blood pumping, because in that moment, when you draw back on that big deer or that big elk, that is what it's going to feel like. So I'll do my jumping jacks, I'll pick my hunting bow up, draw it back, and I'll make one good shot. Now, if your hunting bow is set up well and it's a forgiving setup and you're in good shooting shape, you should be able to hold the bow as steady as you can, control your breathing, and make that one quality executed shot. That's my best recommendation when it comes to hunting. Learn how to shoot under that pressure and make sure that you can shoot, like I said, if you're a little bit uncomfortable with clothing or with a higher heart rate. And one thing I would also recommend is, rather than doing long practice sessions, walk out every once in a while, shoot that one arrow and just think, this is the arrow that I'm gonna shoot at an elk this season, and make it count. Shoot maybe 4 more and head back in the house. Then you can head back out, shoot another one maybe an hour or two later, because realistically that's what you're going to be doing in a hunting situation. You're not gonna stand there and shoot 20 arrows at once and hope that arrow 21 is what matters. Arrow 1 has to be your best arrow. Thank you guys for watching. If this is something that you would like to get into, please head down to your local Sportsman's Warehouse and they're gonna point you in the right direction as far as a target setup or a hunting setup, and get you ready to go out and smoke that big buck this season.